Hello!
Hello!
Welcome to Saturday with the Beatles.
Yes. Welcome to Mask, a new generation. Here on Saving Throw Show, I'm your host, Stephen Pope. Wow, what a week. Let's not talk about that. Let's just get straight to introductions.
Or shouldn't we talk about it?
No.
Not right now.
Shouldn't we be trying?
Actually, right. you know what, Nicole? We do have things to talk about before introductions. Hi, I'm Stephen Pope. And did you know it was Nicole's birthday this week?
Yay!
Nicole can drink now.
Yeah, I've always been able to drink.
Oh, well.
Just I've been always, since, always,
since
always.
Out of the womb.
Yeah. Take it out of the womb with a Nicole 45.
No, I'm slightly older than that, but I won't tell you because I've been told that I shouldn't be sharing my age. Mm.
Really?
It's 26. I'm not insured anymore. Help!
Yeah, that was me last year.
No.
Anyway, we got you a little birthday present underneath your character sheet.
Aww.
What? Ooh. I wrapped it myself, can you tell?
Yeah, with a newspaper from your childhood.
Oh. Sick burn,
we're the
bro.
Same age!
You're older than she is.
No, I'm not. I'm
yeah, and
older.
She recognizes the newspaper from her childhood.
Yeah.
Come
I'm
on.
Late to She's you.
You say that you never have any friends, Steven.
He says, ooh.
I kill. Oh, there's the receipt. Someone grab that.
Wait. I want to know how much you spent
Save
on
that
me.
For taxes next year.
Where should I? What camera should I got? This
I Kill Giants.
I Kill Giants.
One of the best comics ever published.
Great.
I thought you'd love it.
There's a review
feminist.
From NPR on the back.
She runs around wearing good. Rabbit ears and hitting things with a hammer.
Oh, that's definitely everything I'm about.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Oh, I love it. I Kill Giants offhandedly accomplished something that, I assert, comics can do better than any other form of entertainment. It set up an intriguing tension between its narrative content and its visual style, and it really lived inside that tension. Glenn Weldon, NPR.
Thanks, Glenn.
Yay. Glenn Weldon.
I love it. Thank you so much.
Enjoy.
Happy birthday to me.
Yes. And as long as, and we haven't even done introductions yet, so Nicole, since we already have all eyes on you.
Wow. Hi, I'm Nicole Viella. I do stuff at Nerdist. You can come check out. Just show up. I'll probably be there. and you can follow me at ItchyBrained, Twitter, Instagram, and I love you all. Thank you for being here today.
And you play?
Oh, I play Chaos a lot. He's the little brat asshole teen who is actually trying to better himself. So, and he's working on it.
Yes.
He's just like really, he's an idiot though. Like all teenage boys. Mm-hmm. He's just blind
so
to a lot of obvious
Accurate.
Things.
So aggressively dumb.
Yeah. Oh, but last time I was here, he had a realization that he's currently going to, I think he knows that he doesn't like girls now.
Wait. He doesn't
is that
like
why
girls.
He was freaking out after the kiss?
Yeah.
I thought it was just because... Oh wow, interesting. I didn't pick that up.
I mean there's a lot of things.
A lot of dots. Still,
he's not there yet. Oh, he's known for having a lot of dots floating around that he can't connect.
Connect the dots. La 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 la. And currently painting something.
I'm not painting, I'm coloring it in just because I have OCD and ADHD.
And I'm a terrible painter. I'm just awful.
Accurate. Hi, I'm Jack Kelly. You can find me on Twitter at Jackson Alexander. The A is the only vowel. And then you can find me on Instagram at Steak Me Home Tonight. Steak spelled like the food. It's a happy endings reference. I play Buckshot or Charlie Malinowski. He is a metal elemental and he is adorable. That's it.
Cool, hi, I'm Jordan Pridgen. I play Swole, also known as Theodore Ted Finn, who is the grotesquely oversized muscle man who has very terrible motor control and that sort of thing, and has a dog sidekick now named Atlas. And he's
Atlas
a
pug.
So he's Atlas Pug, and he helps with things. And Swole can also sort of shapeshift. In a kind of grotesque way that's less shape-shifting and more
It haunts my nightmares.
David Cronenberg's Plastic Man.
Yeah, he can break all his bones, so... and they heal quick, so he just...
and he feels everything.
Yeah!
I hate it so much. And last but not least.
Hey, I'm Michael Holmes. I play Kid Stardust, who is the Nova, who is kind of, to give you a thumbnail, she's basically the Green Lantern of the team, except she's pink, so I guess she's Pink Lantern, which would make her a Star Sapphire. Thank you. Yeah. And I love you more than Nicole, so there you go.
Wow. Oh, shit. This side of the table doesn't give a shit about anything.
No, we don't care.
My love is impossible to quantify, so you can't love more or less than me.
No, I do.
Well, we do have this love-o-meter.
Beep, 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 beep.
Wait, but you were just making sounds with your mouth.
It was going through me. It was going into my heart.
I don't think the technology like that exists.
Yet. Scientists, get on it.
This also opens gates.
Gates to your heart.
Oh, there we go.
La 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 la.
It's a very special episode of Masks.
And for only $19.99, it can be yours too.
Venmo me directly. Right.
Before we get our first mask tangent of the game, and it hasn't
too
even
late.
Started yet.
It's too fucking late.
Yeah, no, we're here already.
We're there. We live there. We live at the hashtag mask tangent. First off, want to thank our fill-in producer Dom.
Woo!
Yay! Yeah!
Dom Zook, founder, creator, god of saving throw. So.
He's the reason you're here right now.
He's the reason we are here right now, yes.
Thank you, Dom.
Also handsome.
Very handsome.
Accurate.
Very handsome.
What else can
I
say?
If I was an unmarried woman, things might happen.
Beautiful.
It gets overwhelming.
I bet he's the type of guy that owns a lot of dogs. That's the perfect guy to me.
He's so, nodding, yeah. So yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so just, if you guys didn't know, he's that type of guy.
It's like, I've got a dog. Do you own a lot of dogs? Just one.
Mm. How many is a lot?
You seem nice, but...
At least five?
Wow.
Yeah. All right, let me just... This is why I hate props. You know what? We are playing Mask, a new generation. It is a teenage superhero role-playing game powered by the apocalypse. Now, also, you guys get to affect how the game goes. Our Patreon backers are mob bosses complete with minions who run around the city and cause mass hysteria. You can donate to have Swole become a normal human with super strength, or just freak out and punch somebody on accident.
Yeah.
You can donate to have Kid Stardust blow up. That's not a euphemism. She literally just goes kaboom.
Either in a good way or a bad way.
Yes. You can create another elemental. We are up to about 10 elementals.
Steven hates it. So you should buy more of that.
I don't despise it.
It's
just really hard
for me to keep
track.
He told me in the car last week. He hates it.
Do you know how many characters I had to keep track of?
It's amazing. You should donate more.
I predict there's going to be at least one more before the end of the session.
Or you could donate to make Jack really insecure. I like that one.
No, don't do it. I'm already super insecure.
You can have Chaoslot do something fucking cool.
Yeah.
What that is up to Nicole.
Or you can make me lash out, and it's fucking rad. Mm-hmm.
You can actually donate to make any of us insecure. Just buy the 3 reroll pack and give one to everyone except one person.
Oh my god, that is like my...
Yep.
I never buy the 3 reroll pack. Kept, I'm so scared.
It kept happening to me, and I was like, I think Chet hates me. I think Chet hates me a lot.
Here's something that could make the chat be against me or for me. It was my birthday. Get me gifts. I will.
Oh, please. We ran Darkson on my birthday. No one donated to me.
I blame Sean.
You can't blame Sean. He lives in Colorado. Oh,
if it also helps, I got real sick the day after my birthday. So have sympathy for me. Like, I thought it was a hangover.
Maybe
then
we'll
I got
play a
fever.
Game where our birthday falls on... near.
Yeah,
May 13th.
We have the same birthday.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Jordan and I were born on the same day, not same year, though.
I have an incept date. It's not really a birthday.
Like Inception?
No, like Blade Runner.
So like Inception?
Sure.
I was hatched.
You still have a birthday,
So anyway, make sure
though.
To check out the donations tab, and thanks for joining us today. So, a quick recap of what happened last week, because there was a lot...
Yeah, also catch Nicole up on what she
did. Even though Chaos Law was here, meaningful glance at Michael.
I did my best.
He was
He did
bigger.
A good job. I loved it. Have you seen it?
No. I should have.
Actually, Michael, do you want to do the summary as Chaos Law?
We all did really great Nicole impressions.
God, you guys. I mean, am I cool? And like that, just for the whole session.
Okay. There's a lot I really like a...
Yes. There's a lot of and hair flips. Yeah.
Okay, great.
Seriously, we got some on point Nicole impressions last week.
It was great. I'd recommend watching through it.
Yeah. I'm extremely proud of my work.
Done out of love.
Mm-hmm. Yes, very much out of love.
I don't impersonate people I hate.
So let's see,
why?
What did happen though?
Broils the hate.
We fell out of the sky.
Great, sounds normal.
I got possessed. Was that last session?
Yes,
that was last
session. He got possessed by the green / emerald inferno.
And now I've started seeing like strange green figures, but like in the corner of my eye and in reflections and stuff.
We met another elemental who is super gay.
Oh, he's terrible.
He is wonderful.
He's great. Terrible.
And this is everything.
We all like him a lot.
Yeah, except for Charlie.
His name is Breeze. He's an air elemental. He's like super into himself and he has a huge crush on me, but I do not like him.
He does
him.
Not have a huge crush on you. He just loves making you uncomfortable.
He's just the worst.
You're too young for him.
Let's see. I got possessed and fought the whole group, but then we kind of like got knocked out of that.
Because mm-hmm. someone blew up.
Yeah. And then we found out that I had made an agreement with Gregor Devereaux that we would find the Green Inferno.
Wait, I know that too?
Yes, mm-hmm. you do.
You were there.
Yeah.
Did I care?
You cared. Yeah, you kind of cared.
You didn't care as much as everybody else.
You're still kind of having your big stuff. You're having your big queer freak out, so we just kind of let that happen.
Yeah, uh-huh.
And I gave him the I'm not mad, but I'm disappointed talk.
Yeah.
You lost influence over everyone except Nicole.
Yeah. And then, where did we go?
Then
after
we went
that?
To, I think it was Nine Candles, right? To yes. meet up yeah. with the metal elemental, Blue Steel Blue, mm-hmm. whose real name is Steve Blue. Stephen L. Blue, that's his name.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Right.
Who is a locksmith as a hobby, because he doesn't actually need to use locksmith's tools because he's a metal elemental.
He's like a he's like a George Clooney type, too.
Very handsome, beautiful. Very interesting.
He helped us beautiful. Track down Skeleton mm-hmm. Key.
Skeleton Key.
Who's
a bombshell.
Who was part of the crew that stole the Green Inferno, and she led us back to Devereaux. And then we went to this club in Questware,
Da Bomb.
I remember Da Bomb.
To yep. try and track down Red Dragon, who was another member of the team that got the Emerald Inferno. And right when we left off, I was going face to face with him.
Yeah, you found him, and he was saying like, "Oh, you wouldn't be able to see them," or yeah. something like yeah, yeah. that.
But
like,
what was Red Dragon's power again? Did we find?
We don't know.
Okay. You don't know his power. All you know is that
he's horribly misshapen and kind of dragon-like. I think.
Yeah. He's okay, the vessel.
I was like, because I don't yeah, remember.
What, no, no, no.
We kind of referred to him as okay. the vessel.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you know, a lot of jokes and larfs and feels.
Nicole impressions.
Great.
Now and let's see what happens next on Mass, a new generation.
See you next week.
Yeah. Okay, bye everybody. Well, our heroes fight the Red Dragon.
All right. So you are in the middle of Da Bomb, which is this weird '90s clash with super modern nightclub. They didn't card you, Kevin. What are you doing?
I think he's just like hanging out against a wall, just like brooding.
Wait, sorry. Pause real quick. I think we established that you actually know people there. So as soon as the group entered, you kind of peeled off and were hanging out with your real friends.
My real friends.
Yeah, because this is a supervillain bar, but it's also like a place that like
it's an ironic supervillain bar.
It's a hipster superhero.
Yeah. Okay, well I'm brooding amongst
like how there's
all
hipster
my friends.
Gay bars now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know about those. What? I hate you for them.
What?
Let's just say
hipster gay bars. Okay. Okay. Fans.
Right. Let's just say all of my real friends are all talking amongst themselves, but really I'm just silent, like just thinking to myself.
All right. Tell me about one of your friends there.
There's Craig.
Craig.
Love it.
You almost made coffee come out of Michael's nose. Take an experience point.
You just had that one in the chamber, too.
There's Craig.
He's kind of, I wouldn't call him a fanboy of superheroes. He doesn't have any powers himself. But like he acts like he knows all about them and like is really like in their heads and he's really like kind of snooty about it.
Mm-hmm. Does he show up to the club in costume?
No, he's not like that type of fanboy. He's
you
just like
soups.
He just thinks of himself
soups.
As like a cool guy that's like in the know, but also isn't annoying to the superheroes. But he is
totally annoying.
He's like, no, we know, Craig. Shut up. That's the thing. But Kevin likes him around because it makes him feel special. So even though he also kind of hates Craig, there's
you just enjoy having a sycophant around.
Yeah.
Doesn't everybody though?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
There's Carla.
Okay.
Who is a super popular girl at high school.
Oh, man, there's actually a lot of high schoolers
at this. We need to address. Michael went ahead, donated $3, and we have named the high school, finally.
Yes.
Michael, the name.
Finally.
The name of the high school is James F. Starenko Senior High, which is a nod to comics legend and escape artist Jim Starenko.
I'm
going to
write it on the board.
Okay.
Fun fact, Jack Kirby actually based the character of Mr. Miracle on Jim Starenko.
And Big Barda on his wife, because his wife is like a foot taller than him
you
and
said
really
it's Jim.
Hot.
James F. Starenko Senior High.
And that's also a quick reminder, for $3, you also get to add a place to Hyperion City.
Can you spell Starenko for me?
Hold on.
This is important, Steven.
Hey.
I don't know. Matt 510 added the bomb, which is now a plot important thing, so. Yeah. We also have a antique shop called McLeod's in Highland. Creative there.
There's also an IKEA.
There's supposed to be an IKEA.
An abandoned IKEA.
There's a mall. We found out where Charlie's house is.
Yes, we did.
We named two new neighborhoods, Midway and Tenebrae.
Minderosa.
What else? Oh, the Sears. Yes. But it's spelled S-E-E-R-S, but it's
the department store where they know exactly what you're looking for.
Yeah.
That's kind of fun.
Before you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, a bunch of psychics work there.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh, I'm going to say that.
And it looks like the Sears building in downtown Los Angeles.
A former, like, superhero who is, like, a minor, more, like, intelligent superhero, like, someone who'd be your contact, founded it.
I'm going to say that Carla works there, and she has very mild psychic powers, but she also doesn't care. And then there's Devin.
Devin with an O-N or I-N?
O-N.
Okay. Do you have to say it slow like that?
Devin.
Yeah, and you also have to squint your eyes. Devin. And I don't know why, but Kevin doesn't like Devin.
Maybe. I'm going to go ahead and decide that Devin looks a lot like you and, in fact, dresses too much like you. And it feels like he's kind of stepping on your side.
No, I'm going to say that he dresses more cool than me.
Oh, fair enough. I like that.
Like, I'm kind of more punk. He's more, like, classy, hipster, like, cool.
All right, and he also like, puts off this vibe of, like, never trying.
Yeah. Too,
and, like, does it well.
Yeah, fucking Devin.
He's mastered Sprezzatura.
Kevin will never admit it, but he's, like, kind of what Kevin wishes he could be. Yeah. But, like, Kevin wants to be better than him.
Of course.
Devin.
Okay, so it's Devin, Carla. I'm sorry,
Craig.
Devin, Carla, and Craig.
Yeah.
All right.
Craig.
So here's the three of them in one of the many dark corners of this place. It's designed so you can stand anywhere and look really aloof.
Yeah,
but still kind
Kevin
of.
Kevin has a drink and he acts like he knows what it is. Not Kevin, Devin. I said that right.
I can't remember. You say Kevin or Devin? I'm so confused.
You're Kevin.
I'm just saying, we're all underage, but Devin acts like he's already like a classy late 20s
Devin.
Dude.
Yeah, Devin has an old fashioned. He's not entirely sure what that is.
But he acts like it.
But he saw Mad Men and he was like, that's cool.
Yeah. His parents let him watch Mad Men once.
It's been great.
All right. So you're just hanging out with these four?
Yeah, trying to figure out some stuff in it. There's a lot of dots that are so close to connecting, and he's just like, what's going on?
Carla pulls her eyes away from Devin for a minute and looks at you. So, like, are you going to talk tonight or what?
You're the one that's psychic. What do you think, Carla?
Okay, one, that's cyclist, and I don't appreciate that.
Sorry.
Yeah, you should be. Two, I think you're going to talk way too much, so.
Why bring it up at all?
Because if I didn't bring it up, it wouldn't happen.
But then why do you want, me to talk?
Free will's an illusion, all right? I want you to just get it over with so we can all move on with our lives. Also, why were you with that big guy earlier? I mean, I know why, but I feel like I need to ask that right now. Omnipotence is terrible.
She asks questions that she already knows the answers to because she's like, well, it's got
to
be safe.
It has to. She has to ask. These things have to happen.
That's actually kind of great.
I think it'd be fun if she was like wrong just often enough.
She's
she
wrong
like she
33.3% of the time.
Nice.
Wow.
So like usually right, but like still kind of got
to
run.
So that's why she's like, it has to be said.
And it's always strangely satisfying to her.
Yeah.
It's like, oh,
yes. Yeah. Free will isn't an illusion. I can move on with my life. Maybe there is hope for me.
She'll like run into someone that, because like for some weird psychic reason, she's wrong like 90% of the time, be like, I want to hang out with you all the time.
That's why she hangs out with Devin. Devin.
Because that's why he's so cool.
Because she can't guess what he's doing. Yeah, no, that's Devin. Okay.
But he's also like a genuinely nice guy who everybody likes. And
oh yeah, no, Devin's great. Devin came to my birthday party last year. He brought a present.
It's like, whoa.
I'll say that you know why I was hanging out with him. We're on a team together. Do you not follow me on social media at all?
No.
Then
you
I go
just
back
retweet
recruiting.
That one girl too much. And that one guy.
Come on, you've invited her to like our fan page like 4 times.
We really need to update that though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I go back to being silent. I'm going back to being to brooding. Just like, leave me alone.
All right. So, well, what are you doing in the nightclub?
So I think I don't remember which floor I headed to.
I think you were on second. I was on the ground floor.
I think, so I was on the second floor, which you said was like a dining area.
Yeah, it's like it has a bunch of like old-fashioned vinyl booths and stuff. They look like they're from a bunch of different diners.
Sure, that's kind of cool.
It's actually it's really kind of cool.
Yeah, is this like diner? Clifton's?
It's a little bit like
Yeah, I fucking love Clifton's.
So like, none of it matches, and because none of it matches, it all goes.
Oh, Clifton's is my favorite.
You vape?
Place. What? Yes, I do. Shut up. I have ADHD and a lot of other problems.
So I just go, I kind of go from booth to booth, and I don't really say anything to anyone, but I'm always just like, I like look at the people in the bar and I'm trying to like identify anybody as Red Dragon. Every now and then I do what I think is like being subtle, and I'm just like, pretend like I'm having conversations about Red Dragon. I don't really think it's being subtle, but I'm trying to have my volume down and I don't have any real volume control and be like, oh yeah, I heard Red Dragon. I heard a lot of things about Red Dragon. And I just kind of try and like casually walk by to see if anyone like turns to look. So that's what I'm doing. Cause I don't know that that kid Stardust has found Red Dragon already. Brain stop.
I get it.
While you're searching, you find some. You get to one table, and it looks like they have to kind of push everything around. It's actually easier for you to walk in this one little area they set up. There's a man about your size, but the only difference is his mouth looks much bigger than yours will ever be, and it's filled with metal. Kind of sharp.
Oh, yikes.
Looking things.
Oh.
You know, this is Anvil.
Cool.
Oh,
have
shit.
I met him before or have I just heard
you
about him?
You know of Anvil.
So is he known as a supervillain?
He's...
90s-style anti-hero?
90s-style anti-hero.
Yeah, it seems like a lot of the... the Bronze Age or whatever.
Yeah. You get to the Bronze Age guys, people who worked in the 90s and early aughts. You get a lot of these, like... I'm a bad guy, but for the good reasons.
I'm the best there is at what I do. What I do isn't pretty.
Yeah.
That was Batman quoting Wolverine, apparently. Yeah. But.
You get a lot of Batman circa Batman versus Superman.
Right.
Looks like he's eating about as much as you do on a daily basis right now.
So I remember that Anvil is one of the people who...
he was part of the Expendables.
Yeah. So I'm just going to sidle up to him and be like, man, sometimes it's nice to be in a place where people don't look twice for people our size, right?
Kid, you're blocking my light.
Ah, I get that a lot. Ha, 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 I'm large.
He stands up and he's actually bigger than you.
Whoa. I guess everything's relative, right?
I'm large.
Oh, you're shit.
Right about that. High five.
Actually, I'm gonna stop that now. I just wanna say, I'm kind of a fan, you know? Like, I haven't been this big for a while. I've seen you, your work before. It's pretty cool.
He's just kind of staring you down.
Okay.
It's the first time you've ever had to actually move your neck up in a very long time. It's kind of...
I'm not as good at it as I expected to be.
You're really not.
I just haven't had to look up.
You kind of have to like move the entire, your lean back, really.
Lean back. Lean back.
Luckily, I'm a little better at doing that than I would have been a while back because I'm a little more like shape-shifty now. So
yeah, you had to bring that up.
Yeah,
you had to bring that up.
Yeah, it's how it works.
So he broke his spine in the middle of this conversation.
Oh my God, Nicole, stop!
I'm just saying.
Crack. Are your friends disgusting? How do you deal with it?
Look, so I'm looking for someone who I think might be a friend of yours.
I know who you are.
Oh, good. All right. We've gotten sort of popular on social media, but I'm looking.
Yeah, you're Devereaux's boy.
Oh shit.
Okay, no. I am a temporary contractor of Devereaux, but I don't like the guy. We're just here worrying
about. Yeah, you just work for him.
He's kind of shoves you a little bit.
Hey. Come on, you know we're not allowed to fight in this bar.
Wait, with the way that he's standing, it should just push him down.
It kind of does it push you down.
Yeah, sure. So I just like turtle on my back.
There's a large rattle throughout the entire club when you fall. And you're on the second floor, so.
Yeah. All right, let's not make a scene. So my arms kind of go.
Oh.
I push myself up. Onto that, which is my new way of being able to get up from being on the back. I'm like, oh, damn it! I forget how much that hurts every time.
I need a drink. I need a drink. I'm gonna deal with this. I need a drink. Guinness, please.
Thank you. We got you, Guinness.
Thank you.
Hold on. Keep going.
All right.
Look, you know we can't fight in here. We'll both be thrown out forever.
Okay.
I just want. We're just
now,
looking.
Now ask me if I care.
Oh, shit.
All right, do you care?
No. Roll, take a powerful blow.
Okay. Five, six, seven, eight.
That's
I don't
a bad thing.
Think I have any conditions at this point. I have guilty, but I don't remember what that's from. But I'll
that's
say.
From kind of...
Oh, yeah, before we went out. So I guess
everything.
That's five, six, seven, eight. That's a nine.
Thumbs up, everybody.
Whoop.
So that is a... Success in the failure way that take a powerful blow
you,
is.
Don't you add when you have conditions?
Yeah, you
that's
add
why
to,
I got a nine instead of the yeah. eight that I
so
rolled.
So when a character rolls take powerful mm-hmm. blow, you mm-hmm. it's the
I
only role in this
guilty.
Game you want to get lower, you want to get a six or lower. Because the higher the number, the worse it goes.
Bum, bum, bum.
Bum, bum, bum.
Irony.
Okay, I'm going to choose that I give ground and my opposition gets an opportunity.
All right.
So basically, what that means is like, I mean, the way I interpret that, I guess, you can change it around or whatever, is that basically I just do, like, fall over and I'm dazed and kind of, like, just lie there for a while.
He stands over you, cracks his knuckles. Ugh, I'm going to enjoy this. And we cut back up to upstairs,
mm-hmm.
where you were talking to Red Dragon, whose mm-hmm. eyes flash that special emerald green mm-hmm. that you know. Well, when you were glowing that, you were kind of evil.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You hear a loud rattle, and everything shakes for a second.
Okay.
Red Dragon doesn't seem blessed.
Okay. There's a matter that I've come to discuss with you, but something tells me that this probably isn't an ideal time for you. Am I correct?
Never a good time.
All right.
He was like doing drugs of some sort, right? Like
he was snorting something, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
May I have a seat?
Go for it. You want a line?
No. School night.
Wait, does she not know what's happening on the other side of the club?
Mm-mm.
No. She's on the top floor.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of like
how could you not feel what is
oh,
happening?
Oh, no, she did. I just said.
Okay. We split the party. which you should never, ever do.
Except when you do it.
Except when you do it.
What are you getting? What are you getting?
Yeah, what are you getting?
Can you bring the JoJo's?
Yeah, bring the JoJo's.
Oh, bring the JoJo's.
JoJo's,
JoJo's. Getting the last. Shut the fuck up, you guys.
Also, there's a completely unopened jar of peanut butter there from our extra live stream.
Is it? Wait, what?
I'm pretty sure.
Bitchin'. JoJo was a man who thought he was a cookie.
But he was actually a cookie.
He was a cookie, he was right. The man knew what he was.
Yeah. JoJo wasn't a man, he was actually a cookie.
And a delicious one at that.
I'm sorry. So, she looks around, she finds a seat, and kind of sees who else is in the room.
A lot of people doing drugs, mm-hmm. some people not actually having sex, but close enough where you want to call the cops.
Dry docking, as it were?
You're in that part of the club.
Okay. This strikes me as the sort of club where, like, if you called the cops and be like, there's a disturbance going on at the bomb, they'd be like, all right, we'll send someone there, and then no one would ever show up.
No one.
They just hang up on you.
Yeah.
Does it look like anybody's paying attention to me talking to Red Dragon?
No.
Okay.
These might be better than Oreos.
They are. And I believe they're vegan. No.
So are Oreos.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever. Oreos are a ripoff, knockoff brand.
Of what?
Hydrox.
But Hydrox are terrible.
Yeah, they came first.
So what? They're bad. Anyway.
I don't want to insult your intelligence. I assume you know why I'm here. And I'm assuming that you know that Devereaux kind of wants you taken out of the picture.
That's why me and Anvil keep a low profile now.
Ironic.
This is definitely the place to do it. Mm. How? Tell me what you know about the Green Inferno. I'm just trying to wrap my mind around this so we can figure out a solution that works for everybody.
Well, people keep thinking it's an it. It's very much alive.
Okay.
It's very alive, it's very hungry, and it's very lost. And if it's ever inside you, it never really goes away. You might think it's gone away, but it's not.
Is it some sort of alien intelligence?
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Oh, God damn it. He does another line.
Okay.
Just like, oh, God, shut up. Shut the fuck up. Shut up.
Is it some sort of alien intelligence? What is it?
It's loud. It's what it is.
Look, if you help us get to the bottom of this, maybe somehow we can render it inert and you won't have these problems anymore.
That's a cute thought, kid.
I said maybe. Mm.
Oh. God, shut up. Oh.
He's not telling you to shut up.
You just got that?
I've been gone.
His eyes flash green again for a second, and he seems like brace a chair. Oh. Your big friend? You might want to go check on him.
Okay, can I hit back now?
Yes, cutting right back here.
Can
so
I hit
you've
back
been
now?
Punched a couple times now.
Yeah.
He basically got on top of you and just did one of those.
And I think as he's punching, I'm like, hey, let's talk. Let's. And then, so I imagine that it kind of goes, like, my jaw is, like, all broken and stuff, and my face is, like, a little messed up and that kind of thing. And then it kind of, because my bones heal super fast. Like, the rest of me doesn't heal particularly fast. Like, I don't heal, like, wounds and that kind of thing fast, but my bones regrow very quickly. Huh. So my face kind of, like, restructures itself a little bit. And then I'm like, all right, fuck this. Let's do this thing! And then I want to, like, push myself. No, what I'm gonna do is kind of roll back and just, like, 2 feet, like, kick him in the chest for the whole thing. Because I'm kind of like, you know what? I've never gotten to just really fucking wail on somebody. And this guy's a huge asshole. So I'm gonna directly engage
in
a
two ways
threat.
That word.
Yeah!
Layers.
Directly engage a threat.
Yes.
Nice.
And that's a good directly engaged.
That is
threat.
A very good number.
That is a. In case the chat can't see.
No, I think it's because the poster.
Turn
got
that. Turn them that thing sideways or something. Yeah.
Fine. All right. Live broadcasting.
I rolled 11 with my +2 for danger. That's a. Stuff. That's a 13. Easier.
Great. Choose two from the list.
Okay. Bum, bum, bum,
bum, bum, bum. And go ahead and read the list.
So, when I directly engage a threat, roll plus danger. On a hit, trade blows. On a +10, pick 2. On a 7 and 9, pick 1. So we trade blows, but I resist his blows, and I want to surprise the opposition.
Okay.
Because I get to impress, surprise, or frighten the opposition.
All right.
Actually, I'm gonna say I impress the opposition. Because I'm smaller than him, and I don't think he realized that I am, like, actually legitimately, like, pretty
he knows you're
fucking strong.
And you kind of look up to him, too.
Sure.
Literally.
Yeah. Can we...
No.
The theme of the day is layers.
Levels. Like an onion. Just like the Nick Jonas song.
Like an onion, not like a parfait. That was a Shrek reference.
I gathered.
Yeah.
Cool. Except layers. All right. So you kick him right in the chest, and you send him barreling into the wall. He leaves a nice anvil-shaped hole. Actually, he does kind of leave a literal anvil-shaped hole in the wall. And he starts laughing. Oh, kid. This is gonna be fun.
Uh-oh.
I just, like, bellow. I'm just like, ah, let's do this!
What do you three do? Because you, from where you're standing down below, you can actually see this.
Yeah.
You can hear this, and you were basically told this is happening.
I'll be back.
And no, you will.
I go downstairs to observe the swoltuation. That wasn't so good.
No, there's been better.
I liked it.
All right, since he's just been kicked through like a wall, basically, can I use the unstoppable to basically, I just want to like charge at him and like, maybe that would be directly engage a threat. I don't know, it doesn't make a big difference.
What are you doing?
I want to just charge at him and like, just smash through the wall, like unstoppable juggernaut style.
Oh, okay. that's very just like engage.
It's a Hulk versus the thing.
But I do have Unstoppable, which is smash through scenery to get to or away from something.
How often do you use that one?
A few times.
Use it this time.
Yeah, it's still roll on danger, so it's not that different. But it's just on a hit, the world breaks before you. And on 7 and 9, I have to choose a condition, and it can go bad. I don't know.
All right, roll.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna.
Also, since you are now all involved in the combat, I'm gonna go ahead and add 2 to the pool.
Cool.
You get one more because you're the leader and you have influence over everyone.
Yes, I do.
So are we at the like edge of the club? Or are we right in the? Yeah, because I just kicked into a wall, right?
Yeah, you're okay. So the bottom floor is kind of like a half circle with, I guess, balconies going up, and the balconies are large enough to be the dining area, the sitting area, the whatever that's going on over here area.
So I'm gonna say that one of my eye things has been knocked out, and just one is like there, and my mouth like mesh thing has been mangled a little bit. So I'm kind of like, it's going on.
You are so ugly. Right
but now. I'm gonna yell like, we're not supposed to fight in here, so let's take it outside. And then I'm just gonna like smash him through the wall and try and like, we're the second floor, so like burst out and like land on the streets kind of thing.
I just imagine. Goal.
Whoops.
Lommel.
Give me that one.
Yeah. Nice. Yes.
All right.
Okay.
So. The world breaks before me is the official text.
The world breaks before you.
Fuck.
So you dive at him, and the both of you go through the brick wall. The shrapnel that decorates the outside of the bomb, well, shrapnel neon, as we decided, break and just scatter as you two fall on the ground. That was engaging a threat, though, right?
I think that was unstoppable, which is...
I mean, that was just something that adds to engaging a threat.
No, it's when you smash your way through scenery to get to her away. I guess maybe it should be engaging a threat.
Okay.
Because that's what I'm actually doing. But it's just that these are both kind of... I guess unstoppable is really more like just breaking
human
through a bunch of
ball.
Scenery and stuff.
It's a human wrecking ball thing.
Yeah. Okay. So, okay, I'll say that was engaging a threat.
All right.
So what are your two things, though?
No. So you just roll it to break through everything. Okay. Mm-hmm. Both of you go flying out the second floor, land on the city street. A car slams on its brakes, screech, tire horn, the whole thing. And he just grabs your other eye thing and rips it out.
Oh, shit.
I mean, is that going to rip out your eyeball?
No, it's
just... just like taking off your glasses.
Yeah, it's just stuck in. It's more like taking off my glasses.
All right, so you are at a -1 on your next roll.
That makes sense.
That involves sight.
Sure.
All right.
And so, I can still see, like, some. There's, like, a little bit of light that goes through, like, the way it works, but it's just, like, so, like, clamped down with the thing that I can't see much.
So he grabs your other one, rips it out. Fucking four eyes.
Wow. That's a dick.
He's, like, unnecessarily mean.
Oh!
I'm gonna fight this motherfucker.
Okay, Matt510 has purchased Atlas Shrugged.
Yeah!
So... as he rips out your thing, you realize, wait, I don't need it. I can see.
I was like, wait, what?
And you are shrinking.
Because it's always like a pretty painful experience to shrink town too, right?
Okay.
Oh, all right, this is gonna be a very different fight.
Oh yes, it is.
He
says with this large metal toothy grin as roll take another powerful blow.
Wait a second.
Standing on the edge of the wall, I'm like, we should probably get down there.
Actually,
right?
You know what? Do not roll that yet. But
I'm
you
like,
have shrunk back
like,
down to
we?
Normal human size.
We should do
and he seems
something.
Very happy about that. What are you three doing?
He's gonna get a bit of surprise.
We're standing at the edge of the hole in the wall, kind of looking at each other like we should get down there, right?
Can I from where I'm standing, can I solder his teeth together? Since he has metal grin?
His grill?
Can I just like melt
that
his
will
face?
Be unleashing your powers. However, Matt510 has also purchased one of many.
Yeah, Matt!
Love you, Matt510.
Matt!
Love you, Matt. Love you, Matt.
Matt's just controlling everything.
Someone please hand me a pencil and. Okay, Jack. What's their name and what's their element?
So
who's their daddy?
So this elemental is an earth elemental.
Earth.
Uh-huh. This is the one that is really upset that James hasn't joined yet. Mm. So we're tight. Because we talk about my brother constantly. His name is Dirt. Just D-I-R-T.
Mm-hmm.
And he just controls earth. And just like and dirt. So
okay.
Mm-hmm. He's a very simple guy.
He
likes to make mud a lot. He likes pairing up with the water elementals. He's a big fan of them.
Got it. So you see Anvil walking towards Swole menacingly, mm-hmm. and then suddenly a large upside down dome of dirt appears around the two of them as if to separate them from the rest of everyone in the Questware district. You have no idea what's going on, obviously.
Yeah, but I still get the fact that like almost like a little like
arena
has appeared.
Yeah.
And I honestly,
a Thunderdome, if you will.
Honestly, I think after like everything that's gone on, like Swole is like, you know what? Fuck it. I do just wanna beat the shit out of somebody and possibly have the shit beaten out of me. Like, let's just do this thing.
So when the dirt Thunderdome appears, Charlie, you look down and you mm-hmm. see an African-American guy, mid-20s, not in costume, actually dressed like he was going to the club, looking really annoyed.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it, I just want to go to the goddamn club. I had a good fucking date tonight!
He's great. I love
him. I'm basing him on my old roommate.
I love
was Bert. He on a date?
He was going to a date.
Yeah, and she's real cute, too.
She is so fucking cute.
Like Tinder? Like OkCupid?
It was Tinder.
Oh, definitely Tinder.
It was Tinder, so...
But they had been talking for...
But not like
they had been talking for, like, a couple weeks before finally meeting up.
Oh, so it's not like a casual hookup.
No.
This was gonna be a thing.
Oh, dirt.
Does she know? That's great.
I mean, he probably there's some photos of him in costume on his profile.
Okay, okay. And is she going to be, like, super impressed by this?
I mean, she might he be. Won't know because she's in the club, probably scared out of her mind, and he's outside making a dirt dome for two large freaks.
Here is my thing. Okay, if they're fighting also, in the club, would people actually care? Like, would people notice? Because it is in Questware. Like, would people notice if people started fighting or, like, powers broke out? Like,
well, I doubt it's, like, a panic. It's probably more just, like, an annoyance.
All right, so this is what I imagine.
It's like when the homeless guy outside starts yelling at me and kicking my car. I'm just like, okay, fine, fuck it.
This is what I picture the club is like. There already is holes in the wall. It's just people are very special, very, like, really take particular attention not to bust through walls that are load-bearing.
Yeah, people kind of know how it works.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just got like the
any wall with an X, you can bust
they,
through.
They
feel
respect like the building.
I feel like we established that there's like a pretty strict no,
yeah,
like superpower fight rule in Da Bomb.
Yeah,
which
there was,
which he you started.
Broke,
so
yeah,
he totally started.
Yeah, he definitely started it. I was like sitting there being like, all right, no, we're not supposed to do this. While he was punching me, and then I was like, all right, this
fuck
is
it.
Happening.
Fuck it.